many types of shayateen. There is one is called who's called khannas, and that's the one that continuously whispers. And there's others. Rasulullah has given a name of the one who gives doubts. There's one particular shaitan that will give doubts. So when people make wudu, some people get doubt. Did I wash this? No, let me wash it again. So they wash it again. And then after that, did I wash that little part of my elbow? No, let me wash it again. So they wash it again. This is doubt. This is doubt. And if you see any person who's in that, the best way is to get somebody who looks over them and tells them, just listen to me. Yes, you washed it. Now you just carry on. You washed it. Now just carry on, finish it. Yeah? And so, you know, it's some kind of disorder. If you don't get them out of it, they will literally spend an hour to do wudu. Or they could spend, you know, forget. They might do, you know, I've seen serious cases where it gets to the stage where they've done wudu again and again and again and again and forget it, man. The bathroom looks like a little pool by now. You know, there's water all over it. And then they think, you know, what's the point, man? Let me just jump in the bath. Seriously. And then they jump in the bath, and every time they want to have a wudu, they end up having a shower. And then they get waswasa in the shower. Oh my God, what's next, man? You're going to dive into the ocean or something to make sure that you... You know, it gets really... It affects them quite badly. There are some people like a waswasa specifically regarding their salah. So, you know, they get waswasa again. Did I read this? Oh, no, no. And they want to start again. And they want to start again. Again, it's a waswasa. If you just gotta, you know, sometimes you might, if you feel that it's happened to you, you just have to say to yourself, no, I did it. Finish. Khalas. I just did it. And just move on. Or you do it once and say, done, finished. And just move on. Do the next one. Don't allow it to continue, because the continuity of you, if you start accepting it, then it's going to change into a kind of disorder. Now, one thing is waswasa. Next thing is when he comes for waswasa into our house, because he comes to every single one of us, okay? Jinns have been in every single body, right? Are you scared of jinns, guys? No, you're not. You know why? Because jinns come in our bodies every single day. They do. Every single day jinns come. In fact, when you wake up for Fajr, you've got a jinn that's already tied, a shaitan that's already tied three knots over your head. Just over that part of your head. Tied three knots. Every human being, especially the ones that want to wake up for Fajr, there's a specific group of shaitans that are just after making us miss Fajr Salah. So if you missed your Fajr Salah this morning, you had a group of jinns that came to your house and they basically did their little job. So what they do is they tie three knots, and when you wake up, they say, Nam Nam Alayka Laylin Taweel. Rasulullah said this to us in the hadith in Muslim, that you sleep, you've got a long night. And Prophet ﷺ said he'll carry on doing this until he's made you miss your Fajr. He says, if the person gets up, فَذَكَرَ اللَّهِ, if the person remembers Allah, they say, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي أَحْيَانِي بَعْدَ مَامَةٍ, whatever dua, whatever dhikr they do, any form of remembrance of Allah they do, one knot is untied immediately. Next one is they basically go and perform wudu. If they perform wudu, another knot is untied immediately. One of the key things in the wudu that we do to try and get the influence of the shaitan away is to rinse the nose properly. Now, a lot of people don't do this sunnah properly. When you rinse your nose, have you seen some people rinsing the nose wudu? They just grab them and they go. There's a bang there, you know, nose three times with water. That's not rinsing your nose. Some people just get water and they just go straight on top of their nose. That's not rinsing your nose. It's in the inside. Okay, so some people, what they do, their rinsing of the nose is just basically grab some water and just stick it up in there, stick it up in there, that's it, they rinse their nose. And some other people, they want to basically, you know, do the classical one, yeah? You better not watch, brothers. Yeah? And then they release some explosion from their nose. Yeah? Be careful, brother. There's other brothers doing wudu, yeah? Make sure he doesn't fall over him, you know, he's got his clothes over there as well. I don't like, you know, you're just trying to do wudu in the wudu area, right? You got some brothers who are trying to do wudu. I think, you know, are you doing wudu or are you making me do wudu? Because it's half over your, you know, your jubba, whatever, your trousers, yeah? And when the guy basically does a classic one, you just basically want to make sure that he doesn't blow it all onto your, you know, clothes or something. So anyway, the sunnah regarding this, and it's very important, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانِ يَبِيتْ فِي خَيْشُومِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the shaitan sits just at the end of your nostrils, within just your nose. He sits there throughout the night, because you're in forgetfulness. You're not in a state of dhikr. And to get the influence of shaitan away is to take water to snuff it up, up to the bridge of the nose, and then to sniff it out, both sort of parts. So to take some water in is one sunnah, to take and blow the water out is the second sunnah. Both these sunnahs complete cleansing the nose at the time of wudu or ghusl, at the time of performing ablution or having a bath. So that's the second one. The third one the hadith says is that the person prays. When you pray two rakats, the infinite, the last knot that is there will actually be untied.